everyone, it's Justin again. At this point, you've seen lots of parabolas graphed, and you've probably been thinking, when are you going to teach me how to graph these? Well, you're in luck, because that's what you're going to be learning in this video. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to graph quadratic functions that are written in factored form. First, we'll talk about what factored form means. Then I'll give you the steps to write down for how to graph these kinds of quadratics. We'll use that list of steps to go through a few examples, including some tricky situations that sometimes come up. Then, at the end, we'll recap, because there's going to be a lot of information. There are several different ways quadratic functions can be written, and each one comes with its own method for graphing. For now, though, we're going to focus on graphing quadratics in factored form. Factored form is, well, exactly what you'd expect. It's the form you get when you take a quadratic function and fully factor it. The function, x squared plus 6x plus 8, is in standard form. Its factored form would be x plus 2 times x plus 4. These two are the same function. If we input the same values to both, the outputs will be the same. So if we wanted to graph this quadratic function, we could graph its factored form, and the graphs would be perfect matches. Same function, two different forms. But Justin, how do we graph it? Okay, I'll tell you. First, factor the quadratic function so it's in factored form. Then, find the roots and graph them. Use those roots to find the line of symmetry, and then use that x value to calculate the vertex's y value. Finally, draw the curve. Take a second and pause the video so you can write these steps down, so you can refer to them as we work through some examples. Let's do an example now just to make sure those steps are crystal clear. Here is the quadratic from before. Luckily, we already found its factored form, so that's step one taken care of. Step two says to find the roots. Take a moment, pause the video, and see if you remember how to do that. If we set each factor equal to 0 and solve, we get negative 2 and negative 4 for the roots. But how do we graph roots? Well, remember what roots are, the values that cause the function to output 0. That means if we input negative 2, the output will be 0. And if we input negative 4, same thing happens. Have you figured it out yet? Roots tell you where the x-intercepts are. So graphing them is as easy as plotting points on a number line. The next step says to find the line of symmetry, which seems confusing until you remember that parabolas are perfectly symmetrical. If the x-intercepts are at negative 2 and negative 4, then the line of symmetry will be right down the middle at negative 3. If you're having trouble figuring out what's in the middle of two numbers, you can always add them together and divide by 2. Negative 2 plus negative 4 is negative 6, divided by 2 is negative 3. Finally, the vertex has to be somewhere on this line of symmetry, so input that x value and see what you get. We end up with negative 1 here, so the vertex is at negative 3, negative 1. You want to make sure your parabola is super accurate. You can evaluate more inputs and plot their points, but 3 is the absolute minimum amount. Now we're ready to draw a curve going through one root, down to the vertex, and then back up through the other root. There are a few tricks to watch out for. First, if you factor out a GCF, that GCF is still a factor. The GCF includes an x, then that root will be 0. Because 0 times whatever else will always be 0. But if the GCF is a constant with no variable, then there isn't a root there, because 2 is never equal to 0. Remember, roots are related to x values. If there's no x, it has nothing to do with the roots, so no root. But that doesn't mean there isn't a root elsewhere. After factoring out the GCF, sometimes we can factor the leftovers further. x plus 2 times x plus 1 in this case, which makes the roots negative 2 and negative 1. Don't forget, this all hinges on whether or not the quadratic can even be factored. If there's no factored form, we're going to have to use one of the other strategies that we'll learn later in this unit in order to graph it. There's one last trick to be careful of, and we'll do a full example for this one because it kind of doesn't follow the steps that I gave you earlier. This quadratic function factors into x minus 3 times x minus 3. It's a squared binomial. So then the roots are 3 twice. Do you remember what we call that? We call it 3 with a multiplicity of 2. So next we graph the roots, 3 here, and now what do we do with the second root? Here's the thing. Typically, the two roots tell you where the graph crosses the x-axis once and then crosses back over again. If the roots are the same, that just means it touches the x-axis and then turns around so fast that it never gets a chance to cross over. Think of it as bouncing off the x-axis instead of going through it. This is what always happens with a multiplicity of two. So instead of finding two roots, we found the vertex. We can't graph this with only one point, so pick a random input to evaluate, plot the resulting point, and remember that parabolas are symmetrical. So we can also plot a point on the other side of that vertex. Now we have three points, and we can draw the curve through them. Let's run through everything one last time. The roots tell you where the x-intercepts are. The vertex is in the middle of those roots. Sometimes you get a root with multiplicity 2, which means the vertex is on the x-axis, and for more points, you can choose any x value to input, and then mirror it on the other side of the line of symmetry. If a GCF has an x in it, then the root of that factor is 0. If a GCF is just a constant, it's not a root. And sometimes a quadratic is unfactorable, so you can't graph it using this method. That was a lot, I know. So make sure you study and practice. You'll get even more practice in the next video when we graph quadratic functions to help us solve real-world problems. See you then.